I'm Nicole Morgan.
And I'm Cameron King.
We hope you had a great summer break and are ready for an awesome school year.
The whole team here at CCTV is so excited to bring you campus news and updates each week.
For the first time this year, let's hear some stories from our field reporters.
Let's start off to Kayleen with our top story.
Hey Dons, it's Kayleen Afsahi and I'm here with Mr. LaPerry, our president. So, Mr. LaPerry, can you tell us a little bit about the parking renovations?
Yes, I'd be happy to do so. First, I would like to apologize to our sophomores and juniors and seniors that maybe had a little extra stress early in the year when they were waiting for parking spots. The project we're very excited about is going to replace 80% of our energy when it's complete at the end of December. So all our solar panels will produce most of the electric energy that we need. And in the course of 6 years, we should be able to be covering 100% of our energy because we're going to be replacing inefficient air conditioning units. And we've already begun replacing light bulbs with LEDs. So we're using a lot less energy. The exciting news that after 6 years is that we can buy the project from the outside company that's having it installed. It will cost us about $1 million, where the project itself cost about $3.5.
Mr. Aiello, can you tell us about what's going on?
Yes, currently we are in the middle of our solar carport renovation. Throughout this first semester, we'll be switching back and forth from the junior to senior lot, depending on what phase of construction. As you can see now, we have actually gone through the hardest part of construction, which was the digging and coring of all the piers that you see behind us. The next phases will be the steel structures going in place, which will start with a junior lot, hopefully by the 19th of September.
Is this project going to be finished?
We're looking for around December 30th, so when you guys go on your Christmas break.
Okay, cool. Thank you so much. And now let's send it back to Cameron and Nicole in the anchor room.
Thanks, Kayleen. We can't wait to see what the finished product is. Let's talk about what else is happening here at Cathedral.
The freshman dance was 2 weeks ago, and everyone had a blast partying in the USA.
Seniors, the Dean's Office and ASB would like to remind you that we don't have approval yet to wear our non-CCHS gear. Please make sure you're not wearing your college sweatshirts.
Club applications are due soon. Club week is September 12th through 16th at the Forgotten Country Plaza, and applications for new clubs are due August 31st.
NHS is going to be offering tutoring to students again this year. A website where you can go to sign up for this tutoring session is coming up. But until then, if you have any questions, contact Keone Rodriguez at krodriguez2017@cchsdons.com.
There was a great update last week, so make sure you check Schoology.
Freshmen, elections are coming up September 9th, so know your campaigning classmates.
Check out their videos for those candidates and be ready to vote.
Now let's send it off to our field reporters who have more on campus news.
Hey Dons, did you know that 89% of Cathedral graduates attend a college? Our amazing counselors help us get into these colleges. Now let's check in with Ms. Connolly to learn more about how the counseling program has changed since last year.
So how has the counseling program changed since last year, and why did it change?
Well, last year at the beginning of the year, we had a 9-12 alpha split with all students and all counselors. And in January, we chose to move to a college counseling section and a guidance counseling section. We did that so that our 11th and 12th graders could get the focus on the college application process that we really felt they needed. And we also did it so our 9th and 10th graders had a smooth transition into school, into high school, and choosing their academic classes. So it's really just to meet the needs of our students. My name's Christine Conley, and my alphabet is R, B through Z, and I have seniors right now, and in January I will have juniors as well.
Hi, my name is Miss Mitchell. I'm a college counselor, alphabet A through E.
Hi, my name is Jesse Gonzalez. I'm a guidance counselor, and the alphabet that I'm responsible for is last names A through GO.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Young, and I'm the college counselor for the letters F to LA.
Hi, my name is Mrs. Norris, and I'm a guidance counselor. I have the alphabet GP through O.
I'm Mrs. Reed. I'm a guidance counselor as well, and I'm alphabet P through Z.
Thanks, team. Fantastic reporting. Now, let's throw it off to Brennan Wilhite with your sports report.
Good morning, Dons. I'm Brennan Wilhite, and welcome to CCTV Sports. Last Friday, your Dons football team defeated DeMonte Ranch with a score of 49-12 in their opening game of the season. Touchdowns from seniors Adam Eastwood, Jack Thompson, Eric Dole, and Tate Haynes were key to the Dons' victory, as well as an impressive performance from seniors Jordan Jenmar-Keith.
Hey Dons, I'm here with Coach Doyle. We caught up with him to ask him a few questions. So Coach, how have you and the team been preparing for this season?
Well, it really started back in January when we started 6 a.m. workouts 4 days a week and all through the off season, and then take a couple weeks off, and then 5 weeks in the summertime again, 6 a.m. workouts, and then August 3rd we got gear on and really got to play some football and get ready. So we had a nice first game. We've got to come back and follow it up with a great game against Central Catholic.
Sounds good. So what would you say is the team's philosophy for this season?
You know, take care of the little things. That's what our focus is, whether it be in the classroom, up around campus, on the field, in your personal life. Just take care of the little things, and big things take care of themselves. So that's what we've been working on.
Sounds good. And finally, what would you say is this team's goals for the season?
I interview every player individually before the season, and they on their own come up with they want to be league champs, CIF champs, and state champs. So those are our goals.
Sounds good. Thank you, Coach.
Our boys football team takes on Westview in an away game at Westview next Friday, so be sure to show up to show your support. Next up, your girls cross country team got first place in Division 1 at the Vaquero Stampede meet and are off to a great start. 9 girls placed in the top 25, and the team was led by juniors Cammie Doheny and Elle Waters. The cross country boys finished 3rd in Division 1, led by junior Joaquin Martinez, who finished 2nd, and freshman Max Wilson, who finished 6th. Your Lady Dons tennis team finished 2nd place in the first serve tournament at Valhalla High School and beat University City 16-2 in a match on Tuesday. Your girls golf team is also in full swing and is currently ranked number 1 in their league. We caught up with some of the girls to learn.
Hi Dons, it's Marcella, and I'm here today with Jackie Garcia, senior and captain of the girls varsity golf team. Jackie, you've had 6 matches so far. How have you done in them, and how do you think you're going to do for the rest of the season?
We haven't lost any of our matches this year, so that's been really good. We have 2 new freshmen, Isabel Bersalaya and Sabrina Nguyen, that have made a really big impact on our team. We're looking to go to CIF this year and hopefully win continuously all of our matches.
So how did the team do last year, and how do you think you're going to do this year?
Last year we did really well. We made it to CIF as a team. And I, as an individual, I made it onto state regionals by myself, so that was really cool. So hopefully we can do that next year, move on to state regionals as a team. That would be awesome.
So who do you think is going to be your biggest rivals this year?
I would say Torrey Pines or Rancho Bernardo High School. Both teams are really good. They have a really good set of girls on their team. So hopefully we can beat them this year.
Thank you so much for speaking with us, and good luck with your matches next week and on the rest of your season.
Now back to you in the anchor room.
Marcella, your girls volleyball team plays Del Norte at home tonight at 5:30. It's a red out, so make sure you wear red to cheer on your girls in their first home game of the season. That's it for this week, Dons. I'm Brennan Wilhite, and now back to Cameron and Nicole in the anchor room.
Thanks, Brennan. It's been an awesome week for sports.
Well, we're done here at CCTV for this week.
Thanks for joining us. That's a wrap, Dons.
And remember, stay safe out there.
We'll see you next week.
And cut.
What was that? What are you doing?
I just feel like there's more going on than...
I get that you have this crazy conspiracy theory, but you can't just scare everyone. It's so unprofessional.